This is the most extraordinary day, I think, of this whole crime soap opera. It appears that both father and son are implicated in incest, both of them. Let's see, I'll read you part of the article. The investigation has brought out accusations Casey had been making against those closest to her, namely that her father, George, had abused her, and that her brother, Lee, made inappropriate sexual advances toward her once when she was in junior high. The documents show Casey said her mother, Cindy, did not believe that to be true. The newly released court documents show Casey Anthony searched for information on chloroform, types of shovels, that's an odd one, types of shovels, and neck breaking on her computer in the time before her young daughter Kaylee disappeared. The documents reveal Casey searched those items in March, at the same time she was looking on missing children websites. Casey reported her daughter missing in June. Casey claims she left Kaylee with a babysitter, but that person has never been found, and now Casey stands charged with murder. These searches, incidentally, were made while Cindy was at work, not at home, near the computer. This just is mind-boggling. It explains so many things. I have been suspicious from day one, just because of the different things that Casey manifested, the nonstop lying and the promiscuity. These are kind of trademarks of people, incest victims. It's just, it's just so much to grasp all at once. Let's see here. What was I going to do? The email. Keep in mind that Cindy registered, or it was legally registered, to have that new charity trust fund on July 29th. That's approximately, what, 12 days, 10 days, 12 days after Kaylee's disappearance was reported. This was Nancy Grace keeps saying that Casey, or Mommy Dearest, I'll call her, was trying to protect her daughter, Casey. That's not what she was protecting. She was protecting the family secret. She was protecting her book offer that she got for a couple of million dollars. She has not cared about Casey ever, as far as I'm concerned. I see absolutely, you know, remember when Casey was being interviewed by the police, and also the same thing with Lee when he was being interviewed. In both cases, the phone of their cell phones were going off like crazy, and at the same time, the detectives' cell phones were going off like crazy. They were interfering with the investigation, or at least trying to interrupt the interview and remind Casey not to talk about the incest. I am just so convinced of that. There's parts of Cindy that remind me, and this is probably not many of you remember this case, but Charles Manson had an unusual stronghold on these young women's minds, and that they would, you know, and maybe I'm out of line for even thinking that way, but there is something so sinister about Cindy Anthony that just gives me the willies. You are, of course, familiar with the email where Cindy talks about, you know, fooling the FBI with a hairbrush. But I saw something that I, on CNN, at that same time that they were showing the email that was coming, they showed another clip of an email, part of an email, without addressing it. They didn't explain what it was. They didn't explain anything. They just put it up on the screen. Let me read it to you. This is in quotes. "As far as Tim Miller goes, remember it was you who sealed the first deal with me. Having him come in the first place. I also trusted you so much that I let you speak to Casey." Let me go back. Let me repeat that. "As far as Tim Miller goes, remember it was you who sealed the first deal with me, having him come." Cindy, I'm not real clear on this. Was it Cindy that wanted to call in Tim Miller for the public relations? Remember how he sort of, Tim Miller danced around his association with Cindy? He was leaving because we couldn't come to terms, you know, as she wouldn't cooperate. And my question was, what does she have to do with your search? You know, she doesn't have anything to do. You know, I was just puzzled by the whole thing. You know, here the attorney, Bozo, is called by, some people call him Bozo. He's passing messages between the Anthonys and Casey every time he goes. And I'm wondering if that is not in the best, not following the spirit of this, you know, they can say, well, attorney privilege, he can say anything he wants, he can do anything he wants, you know, and he's a big shot, or he thinks he is, you know, with the hugs and passing notes. In this situation, Cindy is so psychotic, and I'm going to go out on a limb here. I think she's taking speed so that she could quickly lose weight, so to better play her Joan of Arc role. If that sounds negative, let me tell you that positive thinking people don't solve cases. You're dealing with criminals, and you need to address them as criminals. There's just so much. Check out the website of WFTV.com for the full article. Neck breaking. What types of shovels? What would that have to do with anything? Anyway, there we are. I can't wait to see what Nancy Grace says today. She's covering up for the Anthonys, and I understand that she has had a, you know, been sued, and things backfire on her, and I do appreciate that. I feel very, very sorry for the police working on this case. This is a monster family and a monster crime. I wish them nothing but a good night's sleep. Till later.